I'm ready to got my first one, yep.
All right, let's go ahead and do this.
Hey, I'm Brad with Kremin. Today we're gonna do a review and show you what we think about our Cool Blaster Mist Control 1000. So this is our Cool Blaster Mist Control unit. This is one of the ways we keep the air quality in our shop as good as possible. This is the 1000. It's a 4-cell unit. There is another unit that's available in 3-cell. It's called an 850. We have some of those as well. They function the same way. These are electrostatic air filters. What that means is that they impart a charge to the filter itself, and also sometimes the particles that flow through them to pull particulate and debris out of the air. It's got a fan at the top. The fan at the top is what actually creates a negative pressure which is inside the machining housing area. It pulls the air with the debris in it up into the MistBuster unit. As the air goes through it, the particles get magnetized or just get attracted to the filters. It pulls them out of the air and it blows clean air out the top. As I said before, this is a 4-filter unit. 1, 2, 3, 4. At the tops and bottoms, you can also see there's some other mesh filters. All those are really for is to protect the main filters from having large particulate matter hit them. So these are really meant to be more of a baffle, just to knock down the heavy stuff before we start drawing really fine particulate out of the air. Now I'm gonna show you a little bit about how it actually functions and its use day to day. This is the on-off switch for the unit. It functions a lot like your stovetop on your oven. You gotta turn it on initially. You should see these two indicator lights come on. If you have just barely turned it on, it's on full blast. You might even be able to hear it right now because that fan's going pretty quick. The goal with these units is to utilize the lowest fan speed possible. The slower the fan speed, the more time the air is in the chamber and able to have the particulate pulled out of it, the cleaner air that comes out the top. Start way at the low end. If that's enough, good, leave it there. But on occasion, you might be doing some sort of hard pass in a machining operation that's gonna create more particulate, more mist than you would normally see. If it starts to build up, it's gonna escape through other routes in the machine, maybe through some cracks in the paneling, a lot of times through a chip conveyor. Point is, you wanna try and trap as much of that as you can in this unit and not out in the open air. Some other things to look out for. These are cleanable units. Because they're cleanable, that means that at some point they are gonna get so dirty they no longer function. When that happens, you should start to see these lights start to flicker. If they're flickering or altogether off, it's probably an indication that you need to get your units clean. Another way you can test them, you have these buttons on the front. These buttons are test buttons for each individual cell. When you push them, you should hear a nice audible sound. You should also see the light flicker. Here in front of me, I have two example cells so you can see what I'm talking about with regard to the lights. This is actually a new shipment of ones that came in for us to swap. We're on a 3 to 4 month cycle where we get new ones from the cleaning service. We send in our old ones, they clean those, they go out to somebody else. On my left is a brand new one. On my right is an old one. As you can see, some of these baffles are extremely close together. Now these are charged in the system. Because they have an electrical charge running through them and particulate is getting pulled out and attracted to them, eventually that starts to build up. And as those particles build towards each other between these baffles, eventually it's gonna make a connection. Once it does, and it burns off, that's when you're gonna see those lights flickering on and off. So you've got a connection established, burned off. Connection established, burned off. At some point, they're gonna grow together to the point where it's no longer gonna be able to burn off any pieces, and then you're gonna get a light shut off completely. This unit on my right would be a good example of one that's trending in that direction. This would need to be pulled out, sent out, and cleaned. You should be able to see the dirt and grime that's starting to build on this. Frankly, the cleaning is atrocious, difficult, and time consuming. It's not something you're gonna wanna try on your own unless you're gonna dedicate resources to that job. Most of the time, it's more beneficial to find an outside service that'll clean them for you. So for our final review, I'm gonna go ahead and give our MistBuster, For our final review of our Cool Blaster Mist Control 1000 unit, We've had varied success with them. They are a good way to keep the quality management of your air in your shop as clean as possible. However, they're not without their downsides. Number one, you do have to keep up on cleaning them, and it is not an easy thing to do, and it's extremely time consuming. Eventually, you're gonna do what we did. You're gonna wanna move to an outside source, and that costs money. There are other units available, like the Mistfit 550, which is another unit we're trialing. That would be like a traditional mechanical filter that's just catching particulate and not magnetizing it in any way or attracting it with electricity. I don't really know yet if those are gonna be better, but what I do know is that you're gonna have to pay to replace those, just like you're gonna have to pay to clean these. The other downside of these, you can definitely overload them with too much particulate matter inside your machining area. You're still gonna get some coming out the top no matter how slow you move that fan speed down. Ultimately, we're a little undecided at the moment until we finish our experiment with the Mistfit 550, and I would give this a 3.5 bananas out of 5.